Page after page, you keep scrolling. Whether it's on your computer or on your phone, a lot is usually happening while you're scrolling. In React Native, it is important to know how you can add side effects when the user scrolls down. In today's episode of How to Animate It, let's learn about animated events with ScrollViews. Here's the idea. We have a long ScrollView component, and whenever we scroll down to a certain point, a header should appear at the top of the screen. When we go up again, it should disappear. To get started, I have created both the scroll view and the header, but for now, there's no animation. The way it works is that using the onScroll callback on scroll view, we can check whenever the vertical scroll position is higher than, let's say, 100 pixels, and if so, we show the header by changing the state header shown, otherwise we put it back to a hidden position. By the way, if you look at onScroll, you can see we're using contentOffset.y to get the vertical scrolling. But this event contains a few other indicators in case you want to do something different, such as knowing the whole layout size or the content size. To animate it, there are actually not so many changes to do. First, we import animated and we need to create an animated value that will hold the translation value for the header. Just to be clear, this value will hold the vertical position, so in this case, 0 or minus 100, and we're going to animate this so it smoothly appears on the screen. By default, it's hidden, so we'll set it to minus 100, and it should be set as the translate style property on the header, which will become an animated view also. Alright, now all that is missing is to animate the translation value based on state changes. When header shown becomes true, the translation should animate to 0, and when it's false, to minus 100. Let's start the animation in the use effect hook. Now the problem with this approach is once again performance related. In fact, with animated, there's quite often a way to animate views without using state at all. Not using state means things could happen on the UI thread instead of the JavaScript one, which is a boost for UI changes. Let's see how we could do this in a more animated way. The way we could think of this problem is the following. If we can store the vertical scroll value as an animated value, then we could interpolate this value to either minus 100 when we're below 100 pixels, or 0 otherwise to show the header. The major difference is that we'll keep track of the scrolling value at any time, and based on this, we'll decide whether the header should be shown. But talk is cheap, let's see the code, right? To begin with, we'll create another animated value that will store the scrolling value. The idea now is that when we scroll, this value should be updated. To do so, there's a very handy helper called AnimatedEvent, which maps an animated value to an event value. Okay, so I agree, the API for this looks odd the first time, but you can see it as a deconstruction of the event object, usually passed through the onScroll callback. Here we say, map the scrolling animated value to the native event.contentOffset.x event value. So whenever this value changes, animated will reflect this change on the animated value too. If I wanted to map scrolling to the horizontal offset, I would need to change y to x. Again, I think it helps to think of it as a deconstruction that we usually do in JavaScript. All it does is mapping a subvalue from the event to the animated value, that's it. By the way, if you're curious, under the hood, animated calls setValue on the animated value whenever the event is fired, but instead of you doing it, animated handles it for you. Anyways, one last thing missing here is the second parameter, which holds the optional configuration for the event. Here, we need to mark it as using the native driver to get the performance boost I mentioned earlier. And also, because onScroll is using an animated event, the ScrollView component needs to be turned into an animated one as well. So we'll replace ScrollView with an animated ScrollView. Now, since we won't be using the state to update our header position, we can get rid of the side effect and the state itself. The only bit we're left with is our vertical translation for the header. As I said, the idea is to interpolate our scrolling value so that when we're past 100 pixels down, the header should be visible and hidden otherwise. To do so, we can say when scrolling is between 100 and 130 pixels, the header should appear accordingly. Remember to clamp on both sides since we want to keep it at minus 100 before 100 pixels and at 0 after 130. See, it works. Now, I have to say there's indeed one difference with our first version, which is that the scrolling is simply interpolated in this case. In the previous example, we had a clear animation playing when the header visibility was set to change. What you should remember here is that instead of the usual callback with onScroll and a component state, we simply use animated values, with the scrolling one being mapped to the current scrolling using animated events. You could also, for example, interpolate the scrolling to a background color, going from a light one to darker tones when scrolling. It's all up to you. Okay, now that you know about scrolling animated events, let's wrap this up. If there are three things to remember today, here they are. If set, onScroll gives us information on the current scrolling position and other indicators, content offset, content inset, content size, etc. To correctly change an animated value based on a scrolling event, we use animated.events with onScroll. Finally, all it needs is a mapping of the event with the corresponding animated values that will be changed on the UI thread whenever the event is fired. Alright, that's it for now. In the next episode, we will look at a big topic, gestures, following what we've learned today. Remember to subscribe if you don't want to miss it. Thanks for watching and see you next time.